put me this close to your dream, like it's right there. You can just like almost reach out and grab it. But then you fuck it up. It's exactly what I did. So, I love to cook. I've been doing it for years. I just absolutely love it. It's one of my favorite things to do. I love cooking for other people. In 2010, I filmed a pilot for a Food Network show. People I was working with at the time, yeah, they worked really hard for me to get this opportunity. Like we're downtown Toronto. We got Blowfish, one of the best sushi restaurants in Toronto, closed down to do the shoot. I got Brett Wilson with me. It was basically like a me versus a celebrity cooking show, except that what I wanted the show to be was we would both learn how to do something, and then we would have to do it. Like, I'm just thinking. Yeah, so there's me and Brad are standing there. We're being taught how to make sushi from the head sushi chef at Blowfish. Production company, we're filming like a sizzle reel and things like that. Lights and camera, people are there, and I just shut down. I wasn't funny. I was afraid. My anxiety was through the roof. I let everybody down in the room that day. But to me, I looked at it as a giant failure for a long time. But now I realize that I know every step that I have to take to get back there. And I understand now what I did wrong, how to change it. Yeah, it's just, I was so afraid to ask for help. I was so afraid to ask for help because I was so afraid of people learning just about how it would take me a while to understand feelings and how people acted. Like, if me and you were talking and you were mad at me, I wouldn't understand how to fix the feelings, so I would just buy you a present. I've done it my entire life. And I don't do it anymore, but yeah. But the Food Network show. So yeah, downtown Toronto, Blowfish, lights, camera, filming, everything's. I'm so excited the night before because I'm that close to checking off a bucket list item. I still have the footage. It's garbage. But I watch it once in a while to remind myself to not go back there. I just panicked. I froze. It happens. But I didn't realize it happened. It took me, 8 years later? So, but I guess this is one of those don't give up videos. Like, I was that close. But I truly feel I can get back there again. Anyways, have a good day.